Let's find out how good your fraction skills are by solving this PSLE Math Fractions question. Sally bought some eggs. She threw away 152 eggs that were cracked. After using 1/5 of the remaining eggs, she was left with 4/7 of the eggs bought. She packed these into large trays of 12 eggs and small trays of 8 eggs. Do you know what these refer to? What did Sally pack? Yes, these refers to 4/7 of the eggs she bought. Sally packed 4/7 of the eggs she bought into large trays of 12 eggs and small trays of 8 eggs. All the trays were full and there was no leftover. There are two parts to this question. First, we need to find the number of eggs that were packed into trays. Then, we need to find the least number of trays used by Sally to pack all the eggs. Wow, this question looks pretty challenging, but I'm sure we can solve this. Sally bought some eggs. Let's draw a bar. What does this represent? This represents all the eggs that Sally bought. She threw away 152 cracked eggs. So let's use a part of our bar to represent that. After throwing the cracked eggs, she should have some eggs left. So this part represents the remaining eggs. Here's where it gets a little confusing. After using 1/5 of the remaining eggs, she was left with 4/7 of the eggs bought. Let's try to understand what this sentence means and crack this fraction problem. We'll break this up into two parts. First, we have this fraction of the remaining eggs. Then, we have this fraction of the eggs that Sally bought. After using 1/5 of the remaining eggs, what fraction of the remaining eggs would Sally have? Since the denominator of 1/5 is 5, let's divide the part that represents the remaining eggs into 5 equal units. How many of these parts did she use? We have a numerator of 1. This means that Sally used one of these. This leaves us with 4 units out of these 5 units. Sally would have 4/5 of the remaining eggs left. 4/5 of the remaining eggs is the same as 4/7 of the eggs that Sally bought. How are these 4 units related to the whole? The good news is, the numerator of 4/7 is the same as the number of units we have here. So we can keep our model as it is. Next, let's look at the denominator of 4/7. Since the denominator is 7, this means that we should divide the whole into 7 units. If we need 7 units in total, and we already have 4 units over here, how many units do you think we can use to represent this part of the model? If you said 3 units, good job! We can subtract the orange units of our model from 7 units. This gives us 3 units. And how many units represent 152 eggs? Since we have 1 unit here, we can subtract that from 3 units. So we can represent the 152 cracked eggs with 2 units. Did you get that? Great! Now that all the units are equal, we're ready to solve part A. How many eggs were packed into trays? Which part of our model represents that? Yes, this part. Sally threw some eggs, used some eggs, and then packed the rest of the eggs that were left into trays. Let's find the value of these 4 units. We already know that 2 units represent 152 eggs. Since 4 units is twice of that, let's do a shortcut and multiply 152 by 2. Did you get 304? 304 eggs were packed into trays. We're doing great. Now, let's look at part B. What was the least number of trays used by Sally to pack all the eggs? We know that Sally packed 304 eggs into large trays of 12 eggs and small trays of 8 eggs. We want to use as little trays as possible to pack all the eggs. Should we use more large trays or small trays? Yes, we should use more large trays. Let's try to divide 304 by 12 first to see if all the eggs can be packed into trays of 12, okay?
Oh no!
Looks like we have some remaining eggs. According to the problem, all the trays were full and there's supposed to be no leftover. Let's see, if Sally packed 25 large trays of eggs, she could pack 25 times 12, 300 eggs. This means that she would have 304 minus 300, 4 eggs left. Now, let's try to use one fewer large tray. Let's use 24 large trays instead and see if there will be any egg remaining. 24 times 12 is 288. If we had 304 eggs and we put 288 of them into the large trays, she would need to pack 304 minus 288, 16 eggs into the small trays. How many eggs can she pack in a small tray? Yes, 8 eggs. So let's divide 16 by 8 to find the number of small trays that she'll need to use. Did you get 2 small trays? To find the least number of trays used by Sally to pack all the eggs, let's add the 24 large trays and 2 small trays. The least number of trays used by Sally to pack all the eggs is 26. Did you find this fraction's word problem easy to solve?